Magandang araw mga bata! Ako si Ma'am Regine, ang teacher mo sa math. Today we will be learning about square root. This is a lesson on their grade 7 mathematics quarter 1 lesson 6. Kaya tara na and let's do the math. A square root of a number is a number when multiplied to itself will give the original number. Para tayo magkaroon ng idea kung paano nga ba ang concept behind square roots, let's have an activity. How many squares are there? So, dito sa illustration na to, bibilangin natin kung ilang square ang ating mga nakikita. Let's start. Ito ang una nating bibilangin, yung mga pinakamaliliit na squares. Ang size nito ay 1 by 1. 1 at 1 lang dito. Mamaya, palaki na ng palaki yung magiging sizes. So, yan ay 1, 2, 3, 4. Yan yung ating horizontal, 4. Let's start. Ito ang una nating bibilangin yung mga pinakamaliliit na squares. Ang size nito ay 1 by 1. 1 at 1 lang dito. Mamaya, palaki na ng palaki yung magiging sizes. So, yan ay 1, 2, 3, 4. Yan yung ating horizontal, 4. Pag vertical naman, bilang tayo, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ang size ng ating square ay 1 by 1. Horizontal ang ating nabilang ay 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Vertical ang ating nabilang ay 4 din. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ang square ay isang shape na may pantay na sukat. Kaya kung apat ang ating mabibilang horizontally, asahan na apat din ang ating mabibilang vertically. Kaya naman, ang mga squares na ito ay 16. Saan galing ang 16? 4 times 4. 4 times 4 is equal to 16. Bibilangin natin lahat isa-isa, mano-mano itong mga squares na ito. Talagang 16 ang ating makukuha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 talaga lahat ng mga squares na pinakamaliliit or 1 by 1. Isang technique para hindi na tayo magbilang ng mano-mano ay kukunin lamang natin yung number of squares horizontally at number of squares vertically and then imu-multiply natin siya sa sarili niya since this is a square. Kaya naman, ang summary natin, ang una nating nabilang ay meron tayong 16 squares. Proceed tayo sa ating pagbibilang. Ganyan na siya kalaki. Ito ay 2 by 2 naman yung size. 2 squares, 2 squares, 2 by 2 naman. Kaya yan ay 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Size ng square natin ay 2 by 2. Yung horizontal na nabilang natin ay 3. 1, 2, 3. Yung vertical ay 3 din. 1, 2, 3. Kaya naman, ang ating mga 2 by 2 na squares ay 9. Dahil 3 times 3 is 9. Kaya kung bibilangin natin lahat yan ng mano-mano, 9 talaga yan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. 9 talaga siya. Kaya yung ating summary, kanina meron tayong nabilang na 16 na squares. Dagdag natin itong 9, meron na tayong 25 squares. Bilang ulit tayo, mas malaki na. So, ito ay 3 by 3 na sukat naman ng square. 3 yung horizontal, 3 rin yung vertical. Yan ay 1, 2. Pababa naman, 1, 2. Ang ating size ng square ay 3 by 3. Horizontal na bilang natin 2. Vertical na bilang natin ay 2 rin. Kaya, ang ating 3 by 3 na squares ay meron tayong 4. Summary tayo, kanina meron tayong 25, dagdag natin itong 4 na ito. All in all, meron tayong 29 squares. Next, tapos na tayo sa 1 by 1, sa 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4 na tayo. Which is yung kabuuan na ng square. Dahil meron tayong 4 horizontal, meron din tayong 4 vertical. Ang size nito ay 4 by 4. Horizontal ay isa, vertical ay isa. Siyempre, ito ay isang piraso ng 4x4 square. Ang summary natin ay, kung meron tayong 29 na nabilang na squares kanina, dadagdag lang natin itong isa. Therefore, all in all, ang mga square na ating nabilang ay 30. Itong illustration na ito ng square ay may 30 squares. Kaya ang ating sagot sa tanong na how many squares are there ay 30. Alam na natin ang concept behind square roots. Later, we'll get to know more about it. Kailangan lang muna nating alamin kung paano nga ba natin na-identify kung ang isang number ay rational or irrational. What is the difference between a rational or an irrational number? Ang isang square root ba ay rational or irrational? Rational numbers can be expressed as A over B, where B is not equal to 0. Lahat ng rational numbers ay pwede nating i-convert into this form, which is a fraction. Kapag ang isang number ay nako-convert into fraction, where B ay hindi pwedeng maging 0, ito ay rational number. Ang kabaliktaran nito ay irrational number. These are numbers that cannot be expressed as A over B. Hindi siya pwedeng maging fraction. Sample tayo. Is 7 a rational or an irrational number? 7 is a counting number. Pwede ba natin siyang i-convert into a fraction? Pwede. Dahil any number, kung ating i-convert into a fraction ay lagi siyang merong invisible na 1 as denominator. Kaya 7, when converted into a fraction, will become 7 over 1. Dahil siya ay ating nako-convert into a fraction, therefore 7 is a rational number. Another example, is 0 a rational or an irrational number? 0 is a whole number. Pwede natin siyang i-convert into a fraction, siya ay magiging 0 over 1. Possible ito. Ang sabi lang kasi ay, sa rule ng rational numbers, yung ating denominator lang ang hindi pwedeng maging 0. Pero kung siya ay ating numerator, pwede siya. 0 can be expressed into a fraction form. Therefore, 0 is a rational number. Another example tayo. Is negative 3 a rational or an irrational number? Negative 3 is an integer. Integers are numbers with either positive or negative sign. Converting it into a fraction, si negative 3 ay magiging negative 3 over 1. Negative 3 or integers, just like whole numbers and counting numbers ay, kung gagawin natin fraction, always silang may invisible 1 as their denominator. Since negative 3 can be converted into a fraction, this is a rational number. Sa pang-example, is 1 half a rational or an irrational number? 1 half is a fraction. Therefore, it is a rational number. Therefore, lahat ng fraction ay rational number. Is 0.5 irrational or an irrational number? 0.5 is a decimal. This is a terminating decimal. Pag sinabi nating terminating decimal, it is a kind of a decimal number that contains a finite number of digits after the decimal point. Pag sinabi nating finite, may katapusan. Kung 5 lang ang inilagay dito na number, 5 lang, wala na siyang kasunod pa. 0.5 lang talaga siya. Terminating decimal. A terminating decimal can be converted into a fraction. 0.5, when converted into a fraction, will become 5 tenths. Natakal na natin kung paano nagko-convert ng isang decimal into a fraction form sa ating video about rational numbers. If 0.5 can be converted into a fraction, therefore, it is a rational number. How about this one? Is 0.222 with an ellipsis a rational or an irrational number? 0.222 with an ellipsis is a non-terminating recurring decimal. When we say non-terminating, this is a kind of a decimal number that contains an infinite number of digits after the decimal point. This is an exact opposite of a terminating decimal. Ang terminating decimal tulad ng 0.5 kanina ay yung digits after the decimal point, which is yung 5 natatapos. 5 lang, wala nang kasunod. Pag non-terminating naman, nakikita natin yung ellipsis, which means infinity. It signifies na may kasunod pa, it continues. In this case, itong 2 ay may mga kasunod pa na mga numbers na puro 2 din. Kung hindi tayo maglalagay dito ng ellipsis, lalagay natin yung 2 na mahaba na mahaba na mahaba at hindi natin alam kung kailan matatapos dahil ito ay non-terminating decimal. Yung kanyang decimal number after the decimal point ay infinity. Hindi natin alam kung kailan matatapos. It goes on and on. Recurring din siya dahil ang recurring decimal, this is a kind of a decimal number that contains digits after the decimal point that repeats at regular interval. Kaya naman itong 0.222 na ito na may ellipsis, ang mga sumunod na number dyan ay puro 2 din. Hindi ibang number, puro 2 dahil meron siyang regular interval. Walang ibang binanggit na number dyan. Ang mga non-terminating and recurring decimal ay pwede bang ma-convert into a fraction? The answer is yes. So, itong 0.222 with ellipsis ay pwede nating isulat as 0.2 lamang. Tatanggalin na natin yung ibang 2 since alam natin na yung ibang numbers kasunod niya ay puro 2 lang naman. Tatanggalin na rin natin yung ellipsis. Ito ay papalitan natin ng bar. Bar sa taas ni 2. Pag tayo ay may nakitang isang decimal number at merong bar sa digit or digits after the decimal point, it refers to a non-terminating recurring decimal. At ito ay mako-convert natin into a fraction. Tulad din ng rules of converting a terminating decimal into a fraction, pareho lang. Yung numbers after the decimal point, ang gagamitin natin numerator, in this case, 2. Kaya si 2 ang numerator. Pero bakit 9? Ang ating mga decimal place value ay tenths, hundredths, thousandths, and so on. Bakit 9? Yun ay dahil for non-terminating and recurring decimal, we subtract 1 from the place value. Ang place value ni 2 ay tenths. Kaya naman, dapat 10 ang kanyang denominator. Pero dahil non-terminating and recurring siya, 10 minus 1 is 9. Since 0.2 can be converted into a fraction, therefore, this is an example of a rational number. Magbibigay pa ako ng isang halimbawa ng isang non-terminating recurring decimal. Sila ay mga rational numbers din. 0.57, 57, 57 with ellipsis. Siya ay pwede natin gawing 0.57 dahil non-terminating siya, tuloy-tuloy lang siya. Recurring decimal, alam natin na yung tuloy-tuloy na mga numbers na ito ay pare-parehong 57 lang naman. Ito yung kanyang regular interval, puro 57 lang yung kanyang inuulit-ulit. Therefore, pwede natin siyang isulat as 0.57 with bar sa taas ng numbers or digits after the decimal point. Converting it into a fraction, ito ay magiging 57 over 99. 57 ang numerator dahil tulad ng ating rules for converting terminating decimals into a fraction, lahat ng mga digits after the decimal point ang magiging numerator. Kaya 57 ito, hindi pwedeng 5 lang, hindi pwedeng 7 lang, 57 talaga. At bakit naman naging 99 ang ating denominator? Dahil ang ating last digit ay 7. 7, ang kanyang place value ay hundredths. Kung siya ay terminating decimal, ang ating denominator ay dapat na maging 100. But since this is an example of a non-terminating recurring decimal, magma-minus tayo ng 1. Kaya 100 minus 1, the answer is 99. Yun ang gagamitin nating denominator. Kaya naman, this 0.57 with bar sa taas niya, when converted into a fraction, ay magiging 57.99. This is still a big number. Pwede pa natin itong reduce into its lowest term. Hanapin natin ang GCF ng 57 at 99. Iyon ay 3. Kaya, pwede na natin i-divide yung GCF na 3 by the numerator and the denominator. 57 divided by 3i, 19, and 99 divided by 3i, 33. Kaya ito ay magiging 19 over 33. Ito ang fraction for me, 0.57 na may bar sa taas. Rational numbers sila pareho. Another example is 0.13479246 with ellipsis, a rational or an irrational number. 0.13479246 with an ellipsis is a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. Kanina, alam na natin kung ano ibig sabihin ng non-terminating decimal. Non-recurring decimal naman, this is a kind of a decimal number that contains digits after the decimal point that does not follow a specific order. Non-recurring decimal ay kabaliktaran ng recurring decimal. Ang recurring decimal kasi ay nagre-repeat or umuulit ng mga numbers with the same interval. So kung puro 2 lang ito, puro 2 lang yung mga kasunod. Yung ellipsis ay nagsisignify na puro 2 lang yung kasunod. Or puro 57 lang siya. Pag non-recurring, hindi natin alam kung ano yung mga numbers na sumunod dito since wala tayong makukuhang pattern. Hindi natin alam kung 1 ba ulit yung susunod dito o kung anong number na ba. Ganon ang non-recurring decimal. And any non-terminating and non-recurring decimal cannot be converted into a fraction form since wala tayong pattern na makuha. Hindi natin alam kung pwede na ba natin siyang gamitin as numerator dahil hindi natin alam yung mga kasunod niya. Therefore, kung hindi natin mako-convert ito into a fraction, this is an irrational number. Any number na hindi mako-convert into a fraction ay irrational number siya. Next, is square root of 49 irrational or an irrational number? Square root of 49 is a square root. When there is no visible index, it has an invisible 2 on it. It is read as square root of. Kaya ito ay binabasa natin na square root of and then basahin natin yung number sa loob. Square root of 49. Pero ano nga ba yung index? Ano nga ba yung square root of? Ano ba ang mga parte ng isang square root? Ito yung kanyang general na itsura. Pag may nakita kayong symbol na ito, it pertains to a square root. Where n is the index. Ito yung number sa labas niya. Tulad ng nabanggit kanina, kapag wala tayong nakikitang index na katabi nitong symbol na ito, merong invisible na 2 dyan. Kaya square root ang tawag dyan. Minsan, meron dyang 3, ang basa dun ay cube root, minsan 4, fourth root, 5, fifth root, and so on. Pero in this case, pag wala tayong nakikita na number sa labas nitong symbol na ito, yun ay automatic na may invisible 2. Kaya square root. Yun ang ating tinatawag na index. So, itong square root of 49, ang index niya ay 2. Itong symbol na ito ay tinatawag na radical sign. Radical sign. It separates the index na nasa labas at radicand na nasa loob. P is the radicand. Ito yung numbers na nasa loob. Kaya dito, sa square root of 49, kung ang index ay 2, ang radicand ay 49. Square roots can be perfect or not. When we say perfect squares, the value of the square root is an exact number. Paano ba na natin malalaman yun? We need to evaluate a square root. And this is how you evaluate square roots. Think of a number that when you multiply by itself, the answer will be the radicand. In this case, meron tayong example na square root of 49. Mag-iisip tayo ng isang number na pag minultiply natin sa sarili niya, ang sagot natin ay magiging 49. Kung magta-try tayo ng 1, 1 times 1 is equal to 1. Napakalayo niya sa 49. So, ilayo natin ng konti. Halimbawa, 6. 6 times 6 is 36. Malayo pa din, kulang pa. 7. 7 times 7 is 49. Therefore, the square root of 49 is 7. Yung value nitong square root of 49 is 7. Dahil 7 times 7 is 49. This is a perfect square. This is also an example of a principal square root. Pag sinabi natin principal square root, positive yung ating sagot. Yung ating ginamit as factors ay positive. Dalawang positive 7. Dahil, aside from positive 7, pwede rin ang negative 7. Dahil according to the rules of multiplying integers, when you multiply two negative integers together, the result will be positive. Kaya itong negative 7 multiplied to negative 7 multiplied to itself, ang sagot ay 49 din. Therefore, square root of 49 can be either positive 7 or negative 7. However, ito ay hindi principal square root kasi negative siya. Ang principal square root ay positive lamang. When a square root is a perfect square, it is automatically regarded as a rational number. Lahat ng mga square roots na perfect square na ang kanilang value ay exact, either positive or negative, sila ay mga rational number. Therefore, square root of 49 is a rational number. Another example, is square root of 17 a rational or an irrational number? Square root of 17 is a square root dahil siya ay walang visible index, automatically na ito ay may invisible 2. Same procedure lang naman tayo. Kailangan natin mag-isip ng isang number na kapag minultiply natin siya sa sarili niya, ang sagot ay magiging radicand, dapat maging 17. Try natin ang 4. 4 times 4 is 16. Kulang siya ng isa. Therefore, hindi ito yung hinahanap nating number. Pero, the square root of 16 is equal to 4. Yung value ni square root of 16 ay 4. Square root of 16 is a perfect square. Siya ay rational number. Pero, ang square root of 17 ay, hindi pa tayo sure kung rational siya or irrational. Hanapin pa natin yung kanyang value. Tapos na tayo sa 4, punta tayo kay 5. 5 times 5 is equal to 25. Mas mataas na siya kaysa kay 17, therefore hindi rin 5 ang sagot. Dahil square root of 25 is equal to 5. Square root of 25 is a perfect square, ang value niya ay exact value, exact number na 5. Dahil hindi natin makuha ang exact value ni square root of 17, therefore it's not a perfect square. And if a square root is not a perfect square, therefore it is an irrational number. At dahil hindi nga perfect square si square root of 17, yung kanyang value pag ating in-evaluate ay somewhere in between 4 and 5. Square root of 17 lies between two consecutive perfect squares, 16 and 25. Nasa gitna lang si square root of 17, ni square root of 16, and square root of 25. Yung kanyang value ay greater than 16 pero less than 25. Estimating the value of an irrational number. Given yung ating same square root kanina na square root of 17, let's estimate its value. Meron tayong step-by-step procedure kung paano tayo mag-e-estimate ng value ng isang square root. Ito yung ating paraan kung paano natin malalaman yung value ng isang square root without using a scientific calculator. First step, look for principal roots with perfect squares before and after the given irrational number. Ang given irrational number natin ay square root of 17. Alam natin na ito ay nasa gitna ni square root of 16 at square root of 25. Proceed to step 2. Subtract the radicand of the smaller perfect square from the radicand of the given irrational number. Ang radicand ng ating smaller perfect square, between 16 and 25, mas maliit naman kasi 16. Kaya siya yung ating smaller perfect square. At yung ating radicand naman ng irrational number ay 17. Yan ay magiging 17 minus 16, which is equal to 1. Next, subtract the radicand of the smaller perfect square, ni 16 pa rin, from the radicand of the bigger perfect square root, which is 25 naman. Kaya magiging 25 minus 16, which is equal to 9. Step 4, make a fraction out of the differences from step 2 and 3 following this format. Difference from step 2, ito yung ating gagawing numerator. Ito ay 1. At yung ating gagawing denominator ay yung difference from step 3, which is 9. Ito yung ating fraction, 1 over 9. Step 5, divide the numerator by the denominator to change it into a decimal. So from fraction form, i-convert natin si 1 over 9 into a decimal. its value is approximately, this is the symbol for approximate, meaning hindi siya yung kanyang exact value, kaya hindi equal sign yung ating ginamit. 0.111 with ellipsis. This is an example of a non-terminating recurring decimal, meaning itong mga tuldok na ito, itong ellipsis na ito ay nagsisignify na may kasunod pang mga numbers, mahaba ito, at hindi alam kung kailan matatapos. Recurring siya, so ito ay puro 1 lang naman. Step 6, round off the decimal into the nearest hundredth. Paano nga ba tayo nag-round off ng decimal into the nearest hundredth? Look at the digit at the thousand place value. If the digit on the thousand place value is from 0 to 4, the number on the hundredth place value will remain the same. However, if it's from 5 to 9, we will add 1 to the number on the hundredth place value. Alam na natin dito na 1 ang nasa thousand place value natin. Si 1 ay nagpo-fall under 0 to 4. Therefore, itong number na nasa hundreds, which is 1, will remain the same. Kaya pag siya ay ating niround off into the nearest hundred, magiging 0.11 siya. Halimbawa naman, kung ang ating decimal na kailangang i-round off ay 0.117, 7 yung number na ating nasa 1,000 place value. 7 ay napapaloob kay 5 to 9. Kaya kailangan nating mag-add ng 1 dito sa number na nasa 100. So instead of 0.11, kung ang number dito ay within 5 to 9, tulad ng example natin 7, instead of 0.11, ito ay magiging 0.12. Dahil we need to add 1 sa ating number na nasa hundreds kung yung sumunod, yung nasa thousands ay within 5 to 9. Pero in this case, 1 siya, kaya 0.11 lamang. Last step, add the square root of the smaller perfect square. Ang value ni square root of 16 ay 4. Ia-add natin siya kay 0.11. Kaya 0.11 plus 4 is equal to 4.11. Therefore, the value of square root of 17 is approximately 4.11. Yun yung ating nakuha following this procedure. Using a scientific calculator, ang value ni square root of 17 ay ito, napakahaba niya at may kadugtong pa yan. Ito lang yung kayang mga numbers na ipakita ng scientific calculator. Kung atin itong i-round off into its nearest hundreds, this will become 4.12 and 4.11, malapit lang naman siya. We are only estimating the value, so hindi kailangan na eksaktong-eksakto yung ating magiging sagot. This is just an approximation. Now that we know how to evaluate square roots that are both rational and irrational numbers, we also know how to estimate the value of irrational numbers without using a scientific calculator. It's time for us to plot those irrational numbers into a number line. Irrational numbers are found on a number line by approximation. We can plot an irrational number on a number line using its estimated value. Kung tayo ay may mga irrational numbers na ibinigay na kailangan nating i-plot into a number line, una nating gagawin ay kunin yung value nila. Ito ay ang kanilang mga estimated value rounded off into the nearest hundredths. Use a number line. Positive lamang ang ating kinuha dahil we're using its principal roots, yung positive lamang niya na value. Si square root of 3, ang kanyang approximate value ay 1.73. Therefore, alam natin na si square root of 3 ay hindi lalagpas kay 2. Siya ay nasa gitna lamang ni 1 and 2. Kung ipa-plot natin si square root of 3 sa number line, siya ay somewhere in between 1 and 2. Hindi siya pwedeng lumagpas. Nandito lamang siya. Dahil ang kanyang value ay 1.73. Since ito ay 0.73, medyo malapit na siya kay 2. Kaya dito natin ipa-plot si square root of 3. Next, square root of 23. Ang kanyang approximate value ay 4.80. Dahil 4.80 ito, alam natin na ito ay somewhere in between 4 and 5. Hindi siya lalagpas ng 5, hindi rin siya lower than 4. Therefore, ito ay pwede nating i-plot malapit kay 5. Dito natin ipa-plot si square root of 23. Last, we have square root of 48. Ang approximate value ni square root of 48 ay 6.93. Therefore, alam natin na itong 6.93 ay hindi pwedeng bumaba ng 6, pero hindi rin siya lalagpas ng 7. It lies somewhere in between 6 and 7. Kaya kung ipa-plot natin siya, malapit siya kay 7, pero hindi siya lalagpas. Dito natin ilalagay si square root of 48. Ang mga irrational numbers ay pwede nating i-plot sa number line using approximation lamang, wala siyang exact value. Say for example, we are about to plot square root of 16. Ang square root of 16 ay perfect square, therefore meron siyang exact value na 4, kaya dito natin siya ipa-plot. Yun ay dahil exact number siya, 4 talaga. Pero for irrational numbers, approximation lamang. Basta tama yung ating pwesto na hindi siya lalagpas doon sa dalawang number na pinapagitnaan niya. Word problem. Grace wants to frame a square picture which has an area of 950 centimeters squared. How long is each side of the picture? Ito yung frame na gustong gamitin ni Grace at meron daw siyang square picture na gusto niyang ilagay doon. Ito yung frame na gustong gamitin ni Grace at meron daw siyang square picture na gusto niyang ilagay doon. Ang tanong ay, ating aalamin kung gano'ng kahaba yung side ng picture, kung magkakasya nga ba siya sa frame. Ang given number natin dito ay 950 centimeters squared, 950. Mag-iisip tayo ng isang number na kapag minultiply natin sa sarili niya, ang sagot ay magiging 950. Start tayo kay 30. 30 times 30 is equal to 900. Since 950 ito, kulang pa tayo ng 50. The square root of 900 is 30. This is a perfect square, yung 900, dahil ang kanyang value ay 30, exact number siya. Yung 950, hindi pa tayo sure, mag-iisip pa tayo ng number kung may makukuha tayo. Try natin yung 31. 31 times 31 is 961. Sobra naman. Sumobra naman siya ng 950. Therefore, hindi rin ito yung number na ating hinahanap. Square root of 961 is 31. 961 is a perfect square dahil ang kanyang value ay 31. Dahil wala tayong number na nakuha na kapag minultiply sa sarili niya, ang sagot ay magiging 950, alam natin na 950 is an irrational number and its value lies between 30 and 31. Nasa gitna siya ni perfect integers na square root of 900 and square root of 961. Kaya naman, for us to find the approximate value of the square root of 950, we have to estimate its value. Iyon ay ang square root of 900 and square root of 961. Ito ang radicands nitong dalawang perfect square na ito. Step 2, kailangan nating mag-subtract. 950 minus 900. Si 950 ay ang radicand ng ating given, square root of 950. Si 900 naman ay ang radicand ng ating smaller perfect square, square root of 900. So, 950 minus 900 is equal to 50. Step 3 naman tayo, subtraction pa rin, pero ang isa-subtract na natin this time ay 961 and 900. Si 961 naman ay ang radicand ng ating bigger perfect square, which is 961. 961 minus 900 ay 61. Step 4, we have to make a fraction out of the difference from step 2 as the numerator and the difference from step 3 as the denominator. Kaya naman 50 yung ating numerator dahil ito yung galing sa step 2. 6 to 1 yung ating denominator, ito naman yung galing sa step 3. For step 5, we have to convert this fraction into a decimal by dividing them. 50 divided by 61 is approximately equivalent to 0.819672 and so on. This is an example of a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. Though siya ay tuloy-tuloy pa, hindi pa siya tumitigil, hindi naman natin alam kung ano yung mga kasunod na numbers na ito dahil wala tayong nakikitang pattern. Pero pwede natin siyang i-round off. Step 6, ito ay magiging 0.82. Bakit naging 0.82? Ito yung kanyang rounded off value into the nearest hundred. Kung papansinin natin, ito yung ating decimal na i-round off. Pag sinabi kasing nearest hundred, dalawa lang. Yung digits sa after the decimal point ay dalawa lang. Kaya ito naging 2 instead of 1, nag-plus 1 tayo dahil 9 yung ating digit na nasa 1,000 place. 9 is within 5 to 9, so we need to add 1 sa number na nasa hundreds. Kaya 1 plus 1 is 2, naging 0.82 siya. Step 7, we have to add 0.82 sa ating value ng ating smaller perfect square, which is 30. The value of square root of 900 is 30. Ipa-plus natin siya dun sa nakuha nating sagot. 0.82 plus 30 is equal to 30.82. Therefore, square root of 950 is approximately 30.82. Using a scientific calculator, ito yung kanyang value. Napakahaba niya and it continues. Rounding it off to the nearest hundreds, this will become 30.82 din. So, pareho lang siya. The value of the square root of 950 is somewhere in between the value of the square root of 900 and 961. 950 lies between the perfect integers 900 and 961. And each side of the picture is approximately 30.82 centimeters squared long. And that's it for our video for today, mga bata. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Ang Teacher Mo Sa Math, for more grade 7 contents. I will really appreciate it if you'd also hit the like button. And please share this video para mas marami pa akong grade 7 na mga bata ang maabot at maturuan. Dahil ako si Ma'am Regine, ang Teacher Mo Sa Math.